Nanaimo, North Cowichan.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Since it took numerous private members' bill from the NDP opposition to get the government to appoint a seniors advocate, it will probably take numerous situations like this to get the government to do anything. The operators of Wexford Creek raised the alarm over what they call chronic underfunding 2 years ago. They said then, 2 years ago, that the funding model from the government wasn't working. This government refused to listen, and it's frail seniors, my constituents, who are paying the price. How can the minister justify forcing Nanaimo seniors to face losing their care providers for the second time in 2 years?
Minister of Health.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Honourable Speaker, the operator knew what the costs were, what the payments were when they bid in an open and fair, transparent process, Honourable Speaker. So it's a situation that we face now that we will ensure that there is a smooth transition to any new operator, that the residents are looked after, that their families are looked after, Honourable Speaker, and we will ensure that they continue to get the high quality care that they deserve in this care home.
Reverend Nanaimo, North Cowichan, on a supplemental.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Work with the operators, smooth transition. This is not a smooth transition. In 2012, Ombudsperson Kim Carter said that continuity of care was a crucial issue for seniors. She said that the ministry had not taken sufficient care to make sure that seniors were protected from the impacts of large-scale layoffs. That was 4 years ago. In the last 2 years, seniors at Wexford Creek have faced the turmoil of losing their care aides and nurses and others, not once, but twice. It is this government's shameful legacy, a legacy of Bill 29, a legacy of putting ideology ahead of the interests of vulnerable seniors. Will the minister finally step in? Will he make sure that these seniors aren't going to face more disruption at Wexford Creek?
Minister of Health.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Honourable Speaker, 42% of the expenditures of the provincial government goes to health care in the province of British Columbia. 42%. The members opposite talk about spending more here, about spending more there, this opportunity, that opportunity. It only takes more money, more money, more money. And yet the members opposite do everything they can to prevent our ability to grow the economy, to ensure that we have the ability to increase spending on health care.